So we're good. It's getting worried for a second there. Anyway, Envious for the most part are going to be sending their players over here towards Ivy. The problem is Happy tried to go for a really quick push towards Olaf, and well, he kind of got wrecked. So now it's going to be NBK spotting the play towards Ivy. The problem is if they continue with this, G2 Esports can just close them in. NBK as well. He's had time to recover the flash. They don't even check that corner. Thankfully, they still take him down before he can do any damage here. And now they're going to be pushed back a little bit as we do see Apex and some of the other guys going back towards the old train hall. Kenny S and Body, though, picking up two more kills. And Kenny with yet another one. Now it's just Scream, but he spins around for a quick headshot. Trying to edge out another one, but no. Shox denies it. And G2 Esports will be able to pick up the pistol round and continue their stride well into the second map here. They take him down, and now the usual second round force will come in from Envious, obviously, as they don't get the plant. They don't even get close to getting the plant, unfortunately. It's just chaos on the bomb site, a huge firefight for control of things. And at the end of the day, G2 end up controlling it there. So they're going to get the advantage once again. Envious, though, a fast stack of their players deployed, actually in various spots around the map, but we do have Happy moving out just for some intel gathering back over there into the outer bomb site. Problem being, though, is that rotations are already going to be in position here, and you already have a two-man stack sitting in the B-bomb site. Normally, the custom is going to be have one be playing here, but with both Body and Shox in this position, this is going to be rough for Envious. Body, though, is actually caught falling back when they may push out. Cancel that, as it does appear as though they have decided to hold it off with the smoke in position. So Envy is going to be waiting on the time as much as possible, and it is causing a little bit of uncertainty with regards to what we're seeing over here on the side of G2, as they do push themselves in. Shots is actually knocked out immediately. Body sitting on the backside here too. He's having some trouble finding stuff. Rotations are moving in really quickly though, but the bomb has also gone down, and Envious trying to take swift control. Two more kills for them. NBK and Body trading things out, and Kenny, he'll hold the line. This goes even into a 2v2, and RBK tapped down a little bit here to 54 HP. Him and Happy, the last two standing, and Happy's up on top. No Molotov for either one of them, so Happy's going to need to assist with this in the hold itself. He can't just sit in the backside anymore, as now they can just double play this one. And so long as the player that's defending the diffuser comes out on top with the kill, then they'll be fine. The kit moving in, and he waits for the peek now. Happy just trying to peek into it, but he's unsuccessful. He brings Body down to 11, but it will not get the kill, and G2 will grab the defuse as they continue forward now 2-0. They've gotten through the force up, and now Envious get into their trash round here, where G2 should have a much easier time of controlling things and trying to build up a bit more of a bank. At the very least, Envious showing some force there, not letting G2 immediately just dominate them in the second round, and obviously not letting them get this huge economical bonus that they had going on Dust 2 right from the start of things by just crushing those early couple of rounds. However, it's still going to be Envious for the most part deploying over here to the back B halls. Already moved all the way through the White Halls and leading up to the box halls now. Just the smoke being deployed, actually, which in theory could allow Body to move up there. But at the same time, the smoke is imperfect in that it allows Body to catch these guys crossing. Now, he did not see RPK, or maybe he did, as he is going to decide to fall back further into the site here now, as Envious do deploy it out. Body will be unaffected by the flashbang that was tossed in. Shox, it's a bit of a different story for him, but nonetheless, he gets no kills, and they catch Body moving back. Shox and Apex, though, and Apex, the leaping headshot onto Scream, tapping away onto Sixer as well. He's destroyed him. They've just got to find XMS. He's being a bit sneaky, but now they know where he's at, so he's been surrounded. NBK is going to finish the job, and it's G2 again, going 3-0. Finally, full investments rolling in here from Envious. Do we see the glass cannon from Sixer? Is the next question. Nope. Unfortunately not. He is just going to go for the AK pickup this time around, and they'll save the op for when they actually have the money to be able to purchase that. This time around, though, it's Envious just deploying again through the white. It's the same thing they were doing on the eco rounds, but this time they're going to go for the quick drop inside of the ladder room and out onto the outer bomb set. As the duo players inside of TCON, Shox tries to take a contact play over here by the E-box, but that's not going to work out. Kenny S finding yet another kill here for trade it back out. He's got a chance at a second, and he's going to succeed in getting it. There's no one to counter our Kenny right now, and it's not just him either. It's Apex with the SMG up close and personal here, moves in, shuts down Sixer, and there you go, another quick one for G2, only losing Shox. That money, well, it may not have been built up on the second round, the third and fourth ones, well, they've definitely got the chance to do it there, as Envious do have to resolve down to their first half by. God dang it. I keep hitting Y on my keyboard when I mean to hit 6. So Envious do just invest. It's actually not even a full half buy either. It's only RPK and XMS that buy a barber behind there, as everybody else is just getting upgraded pistols. And we'll see. It's the same thing from Envious. It's a bit lighter with the player count, but they do deploy through right hells. This time though, it's not actually gonna lead into the B stack this time. They are trying to go for a default, it appears, into the A site, but that's probably gonna need to be changed now that they killed their TCON player. And they do still shift down. They're gonna go for this now and see if they can make it work. But I am not feeling too good about it, personally. As they do actually start to shuffle back a bit here. XMS has gone back up on top of the ladder. They still do have two waiting down the steps in the meantime, though, and in the nick of things, Happy has decided to pressure in. He's got MK down to 55 HP, but in that moment, they were able to set up a support system for it. Apex finding the first player outside. One is able to successfully cross the E-box, and Sixer finding the headshot at range. Shox tapping from range, though, and he's going to shut down the last two to give G2 their fifth round here as they continue to push forward. I mean, Apex sitting at 13k at this point. I think they're even going to donate a gun over to him, potentially. He only goes down to 7.8 after everything is said and done with the buy. But look at this. Six or five completed rounds into the map. Body's already sitting at 10.7k, and he has quite a few teammates just sitting really only $1,000 or $2,000 behind him. So massive bonus already settled up here for the CTs, and certainly playing into that CT-sided advantage right now. You see the guys from Envious trying to hold at Ivy. At least one of them, that is. Happy will hold for a one-for-one trade. It's enough for G2 to clear things out, though, and again, it limits the options of Envious. Envious have done a great job of being able to line up their players and through the white halls and getting up to the box halls, but okay, they've had a pretty shoddy record of actually pushing past it so far, whether that's going down to the ladder room and pushing out onto the A-bomb site, or even just going in through the B bomb site from this point, from that point forward too. They've been able to deploy out, I think, once or twice on the B, but other than that, they've been just destroyed every time they've tried to go for a ramp, upper push, or even outside of the ladder room. They haven't even gotten close to the site, with the exception of the one plant I think we did see a couple rounds back. So with them already having lost one player, they do, with about 50 seconds on the clock, resolve to work their way over here towards the ramp now and try to work their way down onto the B-bomb site. Down below here, Body's waiting for it. Shox is here too. Body's going to peek back out. Scream does respond, but it's not a very lengthy response as Shox immediately trades him out. There's only one left standing, and that's going to be Sixer. Patience pays out for Sixer, though, but the second missed shot is going to put a swift end to his rampage as he moves in there. Shox will put him down, and again, it's another one for G2, and they can very easily, with this amount of money, eat up those losses that they did suffer in that round. Envious has enough, so they will buy in again. It's just once more going to be a bit limited here. You can see RPK down onto the Galil. What are they doing with Sixer? They give him a Deagle. Is that it? He buys armor. So yeah, much lighter buy for Sixer, as he's just saving up really at this point. Deagle with armor pickup behind it. Everybody else does go, as you can see, for the full investment. Sixer saving up for the 2k, that was, I think he went the op really badly. So he is still going to be working with that. However, big pressure about to work its way in from ramp again, and Body, ding, thankfully, is through a wall, so he only goes down to 65 HP and is going to promptly fall back in case they do decide to go through that now. And he'll get up on the Pop Dog, see if he can toss the nade in with the correct timing. Shox will call it the signal. The nade, unfortunately, does not ring through. Shox firing off some more shots, but his Body's turn to see what he can impact here from the other side. The smoke, though, is not letting Envious safely cross back out. XMS goes for it. It's not going to pan out. Sixer's on the other side. He tries to swing in. Body again denies them and Scream's the last one standing. Body a little bit too eager to move in there, it seems, as Scream does manage to finally punish at least one of these guys, but now he's alone in what would be a 1v4 if he's successful about this. He's already taken down one. So now, the bomb on the ground, Kenny and Shock still in the bomb site, and Apex watching in case he tries to rotate back out through the ladder room and go over here towards Z, which at the moment, he might be pondering about. You can see him checking behind it, really having expected Apex to have moved in to the ladder room by this point to counter him out, but definitely hasn't been done, and Scream is going to move himself forward here too. Jumping out through lower, no, maybe not. Very indecisive about this, he seems, for good reason too. But eventually, if he is going to attempt this, he needs to make a move sooner or later. Other just fall back and try to save. And well, Shox and Scream do spot each other at the same time. Scream basically has one shot to one tap from that range, but again, is shut down. So it's 7-0 to start off the match, and we do have the pause rolling in from Envious now. Again, a very much needed one, but we had already seen a similar pause when I think it was 7 or 8 to 1 back on the last map, and it didn't really do much for Envious. There didn't really seem to be a whole lot of changeups made. I think, if I recall correctly, this is when they were back on the CT side. And unfortunately, the pause didn't really seem to do much, so we have to hope that they have some strat that, you know, they haven't been briefed on yet, or that they have something up their sleeve that they haven't really tried, because right now, everything they are trying is just being completely destroyed, and for the most part, it's just sending the bulk of their players through the white halls on top of the ladder room and into the box halls should they lose the players that are inside of TCON and over towards Ivy there. If they do end up getting knocked out, of course, they'll follow through with the play into the B-bomb site, but if not, they try for a default. But the defaults have failed almost every single time they've tried it on a gun round, simply because of the fact that the guy in TCON or the guy in Ivy almost always gets killed, and they just call it off and try to have to go into B. So the overall strat from Envious is... The overall strat play, I should say, the strat book, is very, very limited right now. They're not really changing up all that much. They seem to be doing very similar things over and over again, and G2 has just fallen into a pattern of reading it now. And again, they've got money boosted up here. NBK is the only one that really isn't sitting too well, economically speaking. But when you have Kenny S sitting at 14K, body at 12.2, that's not really anything to worry about. You have plenty of buffers. There's plenty of guns that can get dropped to you while you're sort of slowly losing that, should Envious suddenly turn this around and start actually picking up some rounds. So let's take a look now and see. Obviously, we won't see the effectiveness of it really come in on this round, but maybe something interesting to be seen. Maybe a bit more of a change at this time. And already, this is something a little bit different from Envious now. On the half-buy round, of course, but we do still see them trying to deploy with a much greater amount of players over here towards Ivy. Three of them, in fact, are going to be pushing in this time. NBK, along with Apex, holding at the edge of it and trying to defend against as if they do follow through with the push. And it seems like this is going to be the case. One more inside of TCON, I do believe. That's going to be Sixer. And a second falling back to regroup with the Ivy players. They're going to push with four guys, but no, NBK completely destroys it. The fourth one's trying to push back in. Sixer tried to push TCON. That didn't go so well. Happy, at the very least, trades out this one kill. But it is NBK and Apex that just double team it and shut down Envious, preventing them from really doing anything at all. But that was the half by the round. That was not the, what I hope anyway, what the pause was for. Now they get back onto the gun round, and hopefully we see something a little bit better from these guys. Going to be Envious again pushing through though into the white halls, but not nearly with as many players. It is going to be G2 this time that decide to get aggressive. They've moved in, and I think both are aware of the other party, as the guys from G2 are not being quiet at all about their position there inside of the box halls. They do eventually move back more of them because four stacking box halls is a little bit aggressive. So they need to get some extra presence on the A-bomb site in the event that they do drop down, just to reinforce the site a bit more. However, back over there at Ivy, you can see it. Kenny is going to be in a bit of an awkward duel with Happy, and he doesn't expect Happy to work his way in there. So he'll get the opening kill, but NBK, now with an SMG for whatever reason, has worked in here too. He's trying to stack up some cash, it seems. He's brought Happy down low to 22 HP, but it's now just a standoff, as neither one wants to go for the peak here. Apex seems to be handling things fine, but in that distraction here, it has to a certain degree allowed them to work their way back out. The player at Ivy goes down. Body has spotted the player at E-Box here, XMS, and he's trying to force him out. He's not being met with too much success about it, though. And further back here, well, Body's just going to get mollied off, and Shox is trying to sneak in from the alternate tunnel, looking for the shot. The flick does not meet its connection. Scream's going to move in. He'll get the kill, and now you're looking at Body for the clutch. The Scream will go up into heaven to play into a safe position there. Body remaining very, very quiet about this. I do believe he's going to go for it. But considering he fell back from the ladder, and there's really only two options of which he can move in. But actually, they're not covering for the Z-push right now. Scream's going to be free to take down. And it's just XMS now waiting over there inside of the Hivey Tunnel. There's so many places where he could be playing from them, and Body doesn't know this just yet. In fact, he missed the cross a second ago onto the green train, so he'll jump onto this bomb. XMS can't move in, though, so Body, he's not secure. If he's stuck that, he might have been able to actually grab this right now. X is literally waiting for it. Oh, no, this is not playing out the way he planned at all. He gets the kill, but he does not have any more time. So with that, Envious are finally going to be able to successfully pick up a round here. 8-1 goes in their favor. Body, unfortunately, not able to close out on that 1v1 there. Of course, money's no issue. G2 can still buy right back into this, but in theory, they could have kept the streak going and gone 9-0 there. So from Envious this time, it's going back to the fast play inside of the box. Also, they all push towards it. Shox gets one. They're not even watching for the flank right now, but they do decide to fall back and check it just in time. Sixer swings in there, finds body, and now Shox is your main point defender. He's up close with the op, but actually Envious are going to give this one up completely, and they have nobody watching for the ladder room drop currently if they do decide to deploy from there. Apex starting to think that something may have changed a little bit here, but keep in mind, Envious have not committed yet. They've only changed up the game plan in terms of putting their players in the position to go for the ladder push if they should desire to change it towards that. We've even had a guy rotate over there towards T-Con, and there's another one moving towards Ivy right now. Kenny, he'll look for that. He's still in his position over here. And NVK is going to be your main man to watch out for the push coming from both the ladder room and T-Con itself. XMS, though, is the one to try and make the noise and only gonna look like there is pressure working its way towards B, and oh, nice nade, just a little bit too far, unfortunately. Only brings him down to 72, but it's damaged nonetheless. Kenny working with the op, though. Still waiting for these guys to move in, and it's very tense once again. Envious, I think they're gonna bring this down in terms of timing to the wire here. 30 seconds, and it looks like they are getting prepped to execute at that time mark. So in they go now. They'll try to go for it. NBK dropping back down. Apex spots the cross, but no, can't get any of these kills. XMS, he's not only the one to get a kill, but it's also Scream that finds one too. It gets NBK. Now Shox, and not only him, but Kenny S. The ops are single-handedly poking off the members of Envious one by one. It's down to XMS at 11. He's gotten himself up to the site. 10 seconds left. He's able to finish off the job on to Kenny S, but now Shox is still alive here, and he's going to get free reign to push forward against the bomb train. He has to know he's around the corner here. He's going to work with the op, however, but he gets it on the no-scope. Shox with a huge victory, and they will close out on this round. They continue to go forward, and what's even worse is, again, Envious' economy just gets reset now as they will go up again 9-1. Beautiful round overall from Shox as he comes out with a big clutch, and it continues to show how dominant this new G2 roster can show itself to be. Envious in the meantime, it's struggle city for them as they are back down immediately onto another eco. Deagles for two of them, a Glock for Happy, and two P250s is all they have to work with. Body aggressive. Shox again already finding one. He has no reason to fear them anymore. The bomb down on the ground, and Scream and Sixer both detached from each other here. Now Sixer is going to slowly kind of peek back out, trying to see if he can get body, but not having much luck, unfortunately. Sixer again trying his luck, but he's going to miss it out. Body finishing the job that he started a few seconds ago. And well, now it's down to Scream, who initially had just been playing towards T-spawn here and leading up to Ivy. We'll see if we can do anything from Ivy, but this round again is ultimately a wash. And that's where NBK is going to move in and shut things down. They take control of it 10-1. G2 now getting themselves into double digits here and showing no signs whatsoever of struggling. Whereas Envious, at the very least, going off of that full eco round, they are going to be able to reinvest into this next one. But look at it again, just how much they're struggling to get the basics onto the board. The plants, this is another thing too. We've had this many rounds, of course, they won that single round back on round number 9. But beyond this, and the ones that the CTs have won, they've only been able to plant on two occasions. So they're not even, they don't even have a good track record in terms of just getting onto the site. They're struggling at the very outset of this one, as G2 just kick them back at the gates almost every single time here. So for Envious, though, they do deploy into another default here. They're going to try to go for it, but it's already been spotted. As we can see, Apex spring back from the E-Box. They know he's there. Nade is going to send them reeling back a little bit. It doesn't do massive damage, but it's still enough to confirm their positions. And Apex, what are you doing? This is ballsy as hell, and it works, though. He moves in, finds that first kill, does not decide to stick around for the second. He'll just back out of there and be happy with it. And this is incredibly the amount of control these guys are showing. However, Happy walks out here and gets three kills out of nowhere. This is amazing for him to change his round all of a sudden. This seemed like a round where G2 again was looking to be in control of things, but Happy just turned that back on its heel. Body is going to respond, but keep in mind, he's alone now in the 1v2, but he does have XMS down to 11 and Scream at 71. He knows the bomb's gone down. I think he may be aware they both played together too. A lot is being given away via sound cues at this point, but he's got to be careful against XMS there with the op. He's got the kill. Down at 11 HP. Scream is the last one that he has to try and find here now. As he wraps back out, can see Scream playing it on the backside here. He'll wait. He'll turn his back, though. But he's got to spin around in a moment because Body's going to be sneaking in from T-Con. He manages to dodge it, but Scream's going to go out. And again, he's not looking towards it. So Body, he's going to be able to get that kill this time. And thankfully, he will not be out of time for the defuse like we had just a few rounds back. It's the clutch from Body, and G2 remain flawless. A valiant attempt from Happy, as we saw. Those three kills really surprised. They sort of popped out of nowhere, it seemed. And G2 didn't even really seem to realize what was happening until it was too late. The third kill specifically, there was no reaction to it whatsoever. So nicely done from him. But it's not enough to win the rounds. And that's what it constantly comes down to. His G2 overall as a singular unit just looking better and better. And Body, with a big clutch there, does bring G2 back into a dominating fashion. Envious, again, they kind of go for a weird buy here. As everybody does buy down with the exception of Sixer again. He's just going to pick up the Deagle with no armor this time. They get two AKs and various pistols beyond that. We've already seen this round two or three different times, and it just has never really worked out for them, unfortunately. Well, we see Kenny. They do bait out the shot on him properly and force him away from this one. So control of the T-Con is a small victory, but it's a victory nonetheless. And there's Happy again. Finds yet another pickup. They are going to actually trade the AK back over to his teammate, though, since he got brought down so low from that one. But at the same time, everybody else is basically lit. The only one that hasn't taken damage is Sixer, and he's the player without armor. Body even holding the aggressive position now here in the box halls is denying them pressure there. And man, they really covered their assets in terms of the sprays there. Body just tagging up everything. So he'll hang back and just wait for these guys to push back in if they do follow through with it. But he can make the all clear. And as soon as they see them wrapping out, Apex, it's going to be his turn to shine out here. You can see the smokes being deployed. Now he's got to expect something. The thing is, though, is does he expect four players? This is the thing that may throw him off a little bit. They move in, and Apex doesn't even manage to get one of them. And they know also that Kenny is snuck over here on the backside. Where is Shox looking towards? Certainly not the Ivy position. As Happy is just going to destroy him, almost like he's AFK in that position. Body, the last player standing again, but Body, what is this from Body? One, two, three kills again. Finally goes down to XMS, as the position from Kenny was enough at the very least to force them away from the outer bomb site and back over here in towards inner. But now Kenny is going to have to try and clutch out 1v1 against XMS, but he's not paying attention to his flank right now. Kenny, he could go down the ramp and have a free kill. XMS is thinking he's going to come from CT or inside of Z for some reason. But the thing is now XMS suspects this, so he's going to spin around, he's going to look for it, but no, his back is turned again when Kenny S goes for the peek. The misjudgment on the position allows for an easy clutch from Kenny, and it will again allow for G2 to continue to dominate. 12-1, they are stomping Envious. This is just like Dust 2 all over again. They're not giving them any room to breathe, any room to recover, and they continuously clutch out these rounds. The rounds have been getting closer and closer, it would seem, at the very least here, as we see the player counts getting kind of lower and lower as we go through this one. The past two rounds have come down to 1v1s at the very end of it. And even before this one too, we had another one that came down to the defuse there. So they're getting better. It's just the improvement is so slow. It doesn't even matter from the Envious side of things. It's already G2 just dominating by the time that Envious even find their footing and they have like a 10 round lead. So they don't even have to worry about anything at all, even if Envious do try to crawl towards a comeback towards the end of the half. Happy again going to push through, and he's actually been having a relative amount of success here with the Ivy push. The past two rounds, he's caught a player unawares in terms of what's happening, but responses immediately begin to flow in here. There is going to be RPK and Sixer picking up some more kills from Envious, and unfortunately, well, the response from G2 is just not really going to be that great. Shox chiming in for one. If they win this, this is completely outrageous, as I don't think it's going to be possible. Happy counting for that, the fallback there. He moved all the way through CT and counted it out. And Body, I think, is already accounting for a fail. So finally, we see this light, it seems, from Envious here. And they make a very clean hit there into the A bomb site and pretty much destroy G2. That's the first and only time that we've seen that so far. Body, well, he's going to move in for this one. He's been spotted by Sixer already. There's not really any point in saving, unfortunately, because they're rich. They're just going to buy it on the next round anyway. So we'll see what kind of damage they can do to kind of destabilize the T-side, but it's not going to be much. Sixer's going to take down Body, and we will go into that next round with a 12-2 scoreline. Won't be much better for Envious either way, even if it does go 12-3 or 13-2. Either one is really good for G2, especially if they win the pistol. They basically have control of the map and the set. Well, it'll be a triple op setup on the last round from G2. Body, Kenny S, and Shox all picking them up here. As Apex and the BK will just stick with the rifles for now. Heavy presence on the outer bomb site, and for good reason too, as it does look like Envious are going to take one last crack at the default play and see if they can work it here. Three in TCON, one dropping in. Sixer has found the first target, and Happy has found another one too. And Apex, well, he tries to push in, but down goes G2. NBK and Body are already the last two standing, and there's only NBK sitting in the site. They don't decide to push in towards it just yet, however. They're holding back. They're giving Body the time to rotate if they are going to redeploy. Double op setup from Envious seems to have worked out much better than what G2 brought to the table, but at the same time, the slower pace is going to allow for Body to rotate back in. Another 2v5 would be incredible here if Body and NBK do manage to pull this off. There's the first one. Falls back into the tunnels, reconfirms the position of a player towards Ivy. Scream, though, is going to take down NBK. So it's a 1v4 for Body. And Ace it will turn into if he actually manages to clutch this one out. He'll move in, and they actually don't expect him to be over here towards the Ivy tunnel, but a missed shot on Sixer, and that's going to be very important here. Flashbang onto him. That's going to send him reeling back, and that's pretty much killed the hope as everybody's positioned to counter him out now. So RPK is going to shut it down. And like I said before, we do start to see some semblance of light at the end of the tunnel for Envious towards the end of the half, but it's just so minuscule as they only really pick up two rounds there at the very end consistently. 12-3, it's still a scoreline at which point where if G2 just pick up the pistol, and again, assuming they don't get upset on the second round, they are going to, they're still going to crush this one. They're still going to take fast control of it and immediately get themselves up to match point. And from that point forward, it's one gun round. And they will take control of this set and push forward into the tournament. So just waiting for the players to rip. I imagine Envious are going to take a second here just to recenter themselves. But you can hear the ticking. That probably means someone's readying up. There we go. I say tell if you can't see the chat. Fun fact. If you hear the ticking sound, 9 times out of 10 means that someone's readying up. So let's take a look. The last hope for Envious is going to show up here in this pistol round now. If they can close it out and get a bit of an advantage rolling here at the beginning of the half, then maybe there is a hope for a comeback, but it's going to be dire, not to say the least, based on what we've seen so far in this set. And early on here from G2, pretty much everybody, in fact, it is everybody, working their way through the white halls here. Leading it up to the back of B, but look at the aggressive play here from Envious too is going to move in. XMS fighting one, and oh my god, XMS destroys the entire hit. 3 kills for him before he's finally traded out by Apex. And RPK finding one more. It's just Apex now. He tries to run with the bomb, but he cannot get away. So XMS saves Envious, keeps them in the game. They'll have the pistol, but they're not out of the woods just yet. I imagine we can have the aggressive second round buy from G2 come in, since they did not get the plant. And if they can upset there, then they're right back into the same hole that they just tried to crawl out of. But no, it actually appears as though that G2 are not going to force into this. No, okay, maybe there. It just happens really late. So they do kind of go for it halfway. Some guys are going to leave a little bit of cash left over. But most are just picking up P250 armor buys instead of full-on P250 pickups. Or apologies, instead of full-on Tech 9 armor buys. So they have the extra utility and whatnot to work with here too. Gives them a little bit of a boost. It'll be G2 again that while they deploy a lot of utility over here towards the outer bomb site, they're not really going to push towards it here. And the two that move in to try and fake it, well, they kind of get wrecked. XMS and Sixer both go down very quickly, and they are aware of what's happening. They mollied out ramp. They're not really going to let G2 flood in as easily as they would like, as we do see them start to move out towards it here now. They'll drop in. RPK finds that first kill, and a second one to follow it up as well. They're being torn to shreds here. Body's trying to see what he can do. He's got one kill, a second one. That was his last bullet, I think, and he gets it on the scream. So making the best of basically a horrible situation there. Doing some great economical damage to try and keep Envious low. They are going to be able to eat that up for right now. As G2 do have to hope that they can kind of repeat that going into their trash run now, as they'll save up for their first gun round. In the early portions of this round too, it'll just be, again, your default spread out here from G2. Most of the players watching out for common aggression that we might see from the CTs if they did want to try to just crush them in this round, but Envy, I don't really think that they can feel confident and afford to do that right now. As they're on the brink of being knocked out here, if they make some mistakes due to their own aggression, then I imagine they would be very angry about that and the way that it plays out. And again, as I remind you guys on every map, ignore this. This is all incorrect. The kills on some players are probably right. The deaths on some players are probably right. But most of it is probably incorrect. Happy is not 0-0-0. You know, 18 rounds into the game. That would have been on Reddit by this point, if that were the case. But since time does get lower here, and G2 do need to move in, they are just going to group up here inside of the box halls and see if they can make some kind of a play in there. But there's already two players from Envious prep for it. Happy is actually a bit aggressive about it too, hanging on the ladder, getting ready for the play. As eventually, G2 need to move into this site. 30 seconds left. You think they want to take a bit more time about this one, but it's not the case. They're just going to get, again, destroyed as they do try to push in here. Apex, again, finding the one kill there in the corner. He's always a pain in the butt, it seems, to these guys. But regardless, it's Envious that still close out on the round. And now 6-12. They'll be halfway to the tying point here now as we get onto the first gun round. But this is where, again, G2, well, they're back on even footing now. They've got the firepower. And this is where 99% of the time G2 has just crushed Envious so far between these two maps. Scream is actually going to get really aggressive this time, too, and moves up. He'll take down Apex, so maybe it's not G2 that we're destined to just shut down this map really quickly. Maybe we do have a bit of a brawl on our hands there. They get the first advantage here. Six are spraying in. He's going to be able to get Kenny. Takes him down. Body's still there. So that not clear yet at this point. But Body in the backside there too. It's just not really going to be able to do anything. So he's restricted here for quite some time. Shucks the meanwhile as well. He had to even really move out of T-Con, but he is going to be moving in a second here to see if he can find anything. XMS waits in the cubby at the edge there, tapping on the Scream. Takes him a moment, but he gets him, unfortunately, while crossing back is where XMS is going to shut him down. And now Body tries to move in back here. We're going to see a peek from Happy, but Body shuts that one down. He goes for a second one, but Sixer is able to stop it. And now you're looking at NBK as the LMS. Finds XMS on a cross. He's got to be careful, because that's double peeked if he goes out too wide against Sixer specifically. And Sixer sees it, so he'll take down NBK, and it's first gun round for Envious, as they do make this one a bit more of a contest here. G2 will have to go onto a half buy now and save up for the next gun round. G2 again are actually just going to train this over here towards Ivy, but again, with the utility stack that Envious have, it's probably not going to go so well here. Sixer is pushed back just for a moment, though, not necessarily by over aggression, but there is going to be a big wave of players, so if he can put some range between them, that's not going to be the worst thing in the world. However, he re-peeks it. He gets a bit too curious, and that's what's going to kill him in this case. G2 have control of the initial staging area here, and they're going to box it off on the other side. They will try to boost up. It's very obvious to spot, but the pop flash works out great to counter out that obviousness. Body is going to take down Scream. They find another one on the other side, but they have a big stack of players here behind the bomb train. XMS up in heaven. He's doing massive work along with RPK. They've lost RPK here and Happy, but Happy with him being still alive. Hold on now. NBK's brought this down to a 1v1, and he knows exactly where Happy's at. He's going to move up for him with the deagle shots. He's got him down to 48 HP. He's at 22 himself, but he doesn't realize that Happy, he's gone over to the other side there. And NBK, he's going to be able to crush this in the 1v1 and shuts a round down for G2. NBK with a big clutch. And that puts G2 in control of the situation once again. They are not, again, free, however, to just run away with this match. Envy is 7-13. They still have enough cash flow to be able to buy into this one round here. It's after this that it might be too far gone and that G2 will run away. This is the last chance now from Envious. G2, or Envious, I should say, really only had those two or three mistakes that they can make, and they've just made the first one. If they lose this round, that'll be the second one, and the breaking of their economy will essentially serve as the third. Kenny moving in with the rest of the team now here for G2. They are moving the bomb over here to the back halls of B. But again, there's no sign of a commitment yet. The thing is, though, is that they don't really have a default setup to make it look like it's going to be an outer play. So XMS is allowed inside here, and as they move in for the trades, Happy, he's holding on. That's the bomb going down to the ground right now, but doesn't realize he's being sprayed from the other side. Kenny is going to deck him from the top side, takes him down, and now they're being aggressive. Now Apex is going to move up. He wants as much control as possible of the bomb site to prevent the envious players from rotating in from Z and immediately retaking it. And Apex is going to move forward, but he could get boxed out by the guy in Z. In fact, XMS was ready for that one. He was expecting it. So he takes him down, and now they've lost the man advantage. All of a sudden, it's Kenny and Shox versus the world. Here in Shox, really detached from the action. Kenny, first step to bat, he finds a shot, but he's being pressured up close. He needs Shox to support him. He's watching for a flank, but what? Oh my god, Kenny gets an incredible kill against Sixer. I didn't even see the flick. He hits that shot somehow, and it's another round for G2. They're shooting ahead again, 14-7. What was that last shot? Envious are broken. They have nothing left now, and G2 has control of the matchup. I have no clue what that last shot was. That was the craziest op flick I've ever seen. So we have to see if Envious can do anything about this now, as G2 are going to move in here. XMS up on the bomb train platform. He does take down NBK. Body, though, has an angle against XMS, but no, he can't actually finish the job, and he's going to be boxed out. RPK finds another one too. G2 are falling apart here. Kenny and Shox, they'll be pushed into the backside, and Kenny specifically here trying to be very, very careful about his positioning. Shox, as we can see, moves in. Kenny finds a nice shot. He's feeling it right now, so you don't want to mess with Kenny, as they will try to battle this round back. Timing is not really an issue here for G2 at this point. There's still a minute left on the clock. But the players from Envious here still remain quiet as well. Scream, thankfully, is working on a flank right now. He only has the deal to work with, so he's going to be a little bit weaker. But they are not watching out for this flank at all right now. He'll move himself forward and look for this one. He sees the scope moving in, and we see Scream finding that first shot onto Kenny there. Shox, well, he's going to be pretty low here, and it is going to be a fast shutdown. Amazingly, though, I mean, at the very end, they're able to get the plant, which I didn't even expect them to get that, to be completely honest. So they get that little bit of bonus cash here, but Envious are going to strike back. So again, they're still fighting for this. They still have that opportunity here. That force up that came in was going to be the last straw. But they finally hold on, and they're fighting back. Like I said at the beginning of the half, it's going to be a long and gruesome road, especially with Kenny playing like the way he was in that last round there. But they have found a way back into it now. That was, I still can't believe that flick. Well, Envious have themselves what will probably be a bit of an easier time here now, as G2 is essentially going to be on just their half by. Shox is the exception, though, and he could be the X factor as he moves in and finds that first kill. XMS, nicely done, gets the clotheslineer onto Apex to take him back down. Four remain for Envious, and most of them are corralling around the Ivy push now, just to make sure they don't push in successfully and kind of box out the site for the remaining CTs. But they also need to watch out for these other angles too, as G2 is going to be keeping themselves very, very, very quiet. Still seen again, nothing really happening here across the map. As G2, they have themselves lined up for it, but this is all just the timing factor of it and waiting for the right moment to try and deploy in. And NBK, you can see over there in the box holes too, trying to make some noise, firing off a shot or two, but eventually he's still going to fall back over here towards the ladder room to get ready for the eventual A push to move back in. Scream holding himself back over here behind the E box as he waits for the play to come back in. Again, G2, they're not giving them anything at this point. They need to go in. 25 seconds. They're going to have to run the gauntlet here to get that bomb onto the ground still. So finally they move in. But look, all the distractions. There's nobody watching this side right now. And he's going to walk right up. Body just gets a free kill. Thankfully, he doesn't check on the top of the train. But that's a huge mistake in theory if that goes too much farther than that one. If he actually does check the top train and takes down the guy up there too. So a little bit weird there, but thankfully they still manage it. And Envious get their ninth. G2 though, back onto another save. They're saving up. They're saving up in big regards to this one too, as they want to focus on this next gun round in a big dividend. They just go for the half by on some players again here, and most are just actually going to pick up the upgraded pistol. They will try to flood their way in back over here into the B bomb site with RPK sitting up on top of the train. And RPK could have himself a nice little spree here too if he catches all three of them. That will try to move their way back down. Two are going to go up top. Happy though is waiting for this one. The flashbang does not hit him as much as they would have wanted here. Gets the second one, although it hits him through some part of the bomb train. It didn't look like it did, but apparently it was the case. Body is going to grab that kill into RPK. NBK still sits alive at 39 HP. And also, we're going to see another kill for Body there. Scream trades it back. This could be the round. This is a 3v3. The one thing, however, that Envious do have going for them is that G2 don't really have any control of this bomb yard at all. It's very easy for the guys from Envious to move in and crunch them. They don't have any room to maneuver here. Sixer's going to jump down. They haven't looked for Apex yet. And Apex is going to swing out. He gets one. Happy shuts it down. And Scream, with a quick reaction, will take out Kenny S. So it's going to be another retake for the guys on Envious. They bring it up to 10 to 14. And we do continue. We do have ourselves a bit of a match now. But this is coming up on another gun round, I do believe, anyway, for the G2 roster. Yeah, they have so much money now. So they are definitely going to be investing here. And they could even try for like a double op or something like that on T side if they really want to do it. They have the cash flow now to work with that one. They just need this one or two more rounds. You can see it on the Envious side. If they can wipe Envious without having any of them save here, then they can still put them onto a very pitiful force buy, and that is where eventually G2 can still close out this match. But if they don't do it soon, I mean, Envious, the scoreline is closing in. This is certainly a possibility now for them to ring it back and take it to a third map. And that is where things will get really interesting, as I don't think anybody after that, coming off of the first half here, was expecting Envious to ring the comeback. But again, everything goes quiet as G2, they don't make a sound. Very, very passive T side here to start things off. Lining up into what, for all intents and purposes, is just a 2-1-2 default into the outer bomb site. But they're not giving anything away just yet. They want to run that timer down a little bit more here. Scream and some of the others are holding back. XMS is going to try to push forward. The flashbang is perfect against Shox. They will take him out of the picture. And now more of them are going to move their way in from the Ivy Tunnel 2. Body trying to look for the entry. Can't get it. Kenny S catches the trade, but he's counter-traded by Sixer. So he'll go down. Scream finding another one up on the site. NBK. It's another gun round gone to the wash for the guys on G2. Not finding the impact that they hoped for here. And overall, Envy is controlling the situation very well. NBK, we'll see what he can do. 30 seconds left, so semi-decent amount of time to play with here. And he's got the bomb, but eventually peeking wide into the short lane there. Sixer is just going to take him down. So we're three away from the comeback being completed here from Envious, rounding this back on its heels over to G2. And it'll take us through another G2 half buy as well. They do manage to get Apex and AK for this one, as he does. I'm trying to see if he had to force center, if he just had. Yeah, he had a little bit more cash than the rest of his team, so he could kind of afford that. But the rest of these guys, unfortunately, were way too low. They were not able to go for it. The rest are actually just going to push in through Ivy. And I mean, here's the thing, right? Is this is getting repetitive now. Envious know to watch out for this one. Apex is going to be the one thing that could change it. But as I say that, however, NBK gets a very important kill against Sixer. XMS, he's struggling between a rock and a hard place. He's now been wedged in here. Finds the first kill. Still hunting for Apex, however. And RPK is trying to help out with him a little bit here. Apex remaining a bit of a mystery. But no, they catch him on the cross and he's shift walking across the divide. Now that's where RPK is actually going to be able to close out on those last two kills. Apex moved a little bit quicker. He might have actually been able to escape and work his way into the short lane. But not the case, and it's another one for Envy, as they're also building up a bit of a bank for themselves too. The problem being though is theirs consistently gets reduced all the time by the rebuys. G2, even on ecos, are doing damage, but they're sitting on, I think, full losing bonus now. Yeah, G2 has the full losing bonus. While they don't have plant bonus from the last round, you can see it. They have enough to get the op on board, along with the four rifles and full utility for those rifles. So it'll be G2 again, working their way towards the box cells here with the bomb in check. Don't know yet if this is going to be a commitment or if they're just trying to make some noise here, but Envious has gotten aggressive to put a stop to it regardless, and well, hook, line, and sinker. NBK just walks right into the trap that Happy has set for these guys. He's gonna pick up a kill against NBK. And the rest of G2 here now getting ready to spread out. And fall back mainly from Ivy, it looks like, to regroup. Again, it's still a bit unclear in terms of where they're gonna take this, but depending on if Kenny works his way either up to the right halls or if he falls back, this is probably gonna turn into a default or just the commitment to B. But again, they just peek out. There's no flashes or anything like that. Happy fell back to that position. It'll be safe to molly it off now. They're making a whole lot of noise, but this is not where the play is going to work its way towards right now. They haven't pulled rotates off of A, which I imagine was their intention here. They move in. It's a great shot from Body to open things up a little bit, but there's still plenty more targets to knock out on this site itself. XMS actually gets brought down, though, and that's where things are dangerous, because Scream, there's no trade set up for him at all here. It's free kill as soon as he goes down, and they see Scream on top of the boost. That's very obvious, as he's just standing in the open. 3v2 now. But they're being given a lot of room to rotate back in. Happy, oh, on the backside, but Happy does a backflip, unfortunately, as Kenny S shuts him down. And RPK, the same story for him. Shox, it's shut down. Or Shox shuts down RPK, I should say. And this is the more dominant form from G2 that they go back to. Finally, after so many rounds with Envy is dominating here, G2 does get themselves up to the match point. But they're not in safe waters. They still need to actually close it out. Envious, of course, investing in. And oh, all right, calm down, boys. Shox will get a nice little tap to the back there. Not a big deal. 78 HP. And we will see on the G2 end of things here. Body along with... Don't mind that, guys. He's just looking into the fence. Everybody just took a 3-second pause. It was agreed upon. But the guys over here from G2 are going to move their way over here towards the Ivy position. And they just re-smoke this as well. So G2 is actually going to have a bit of a hard time. The utility being used, that's the thing, is that Envy is overall, they're low on utility. So even with the smoke being redeployed now, it'll go away eventually. And they'll still have plenty of time to move in. And Happy, what are you doing moving out? He just gets destroyed by Body. Goes for an aggressive play. The flashbang doesn't connect the way he wanted it to. And he'll pay the price. So they move in here, and they're just going to crush the B-bomb site. XMS! He holds, though. He does not fall back, but he doesn't realize that he's been flanked, or he realizes far too late. Apex is going to take him down. They attempt to smoke at the site. Scream's just going to go for it here. Nice tap from Scream there to take out Apex, but there's a lot more work to be done. The bomb has been dropped on the site at the very least, and he's expecting Kenny, but Kenny, again, he's on point right now. You can't stop him. He moves in. He finds Scream, and now Sixer is the last man alive, the last hope for Envious to stop this from an 0-2. And all he has to clutch it with is a UMP. He just used his only flashbang there as well. He's going to rotate back in. I think this might play into Kenny, though. This might be a quick headshot from him if he jumps up on top of that little spindle there. And it looks like he might oblige to. But actually, Kenny fell back, so Sixer was given the room. He'll move in. They're giving him a lot of room to play with, but here's the thing. They can just peek back in together here and shut him down. The nade goes deep. Actually misses completely, so it's not really going to connect at all. But look at this. Look, Sixer didn't even really attempt it, so it's going to be a team ace from G2 to close it out. NBK gets the final kill, and G2, guys, they will take control of this set 2-0, showing some problems very clearly on their